So what I'm saying that this is a JavaScript pop-up. So you will not going to have any HTML code for that. So to handle it, we have to first tell our WebDriver object to first switch to this alert box, and after that you have to perform the operation. So how we going to do that? See here. So let me first open this website URL. So if I come here and okay, so let me first create WebDriver. To invoke my Chrome browser, I have to set some property, as you all know. This is the key and it is the value. That means search where the Chrome is located in my chrome.exe file is located in my downloads folder. So I think it is the one. So copy this path and after that provide here. So after that, what I will do, I have to create one object of my Chrome driver. Chrome driver. Okay, after that okay, capital V will come here, import the package, and after that import the package from here as well. Okay, so here we have to provide the file name as well at the end, otherwise it will not work. Okay, so after that let me open the website driver.get. So if I come here, so this is the website. Copy this. Okay, after that website, if I come here, okay, I think I have closed the Chrome browser. Okay, let me open it again.
Sunil, sorry to interrupt. What is the agenda today?
So, have we joined late?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Okay, so here we will see first how to handle alert. JavaScript, this is JavaScript alert in Selenium. And second is how to handle with the authentication pop-up, and we will also see how to work with this tool. Okay, I will be coming to this third point later in this lecture. So as of now, we are discussing this first point, which is how we can handle JavaScript alert in Selenium. Okay, is it clear?
Okay, well, yeah, okay, thanks.
So copy the URL. Let me open one website. So this is the website. So if I click this, you will see there is one JavaScript alert. So this alert is not a part of HTML. So to handle it, we cannot write any Selenium code for that you have to click on this OK button with the help of click method, right? Because it is a JavaScript alert. So to handle that, some Selenium guys have provided some methods. So let us see. So to invoke, to click this, first we have to click this clear, click me, then you will got this pop. So let me write one XPath or CSS for this. So how we can write it is very easy, as you all know. So click this. So let me go with this one. Button on click equals to value. So tag name at the rate on click equals to, this is the value. So this is one relevant value. So this is our XPath. So let me quickly write the XPath here. What I will do, I will say driver dot find element y dot XPath. So this is my XPath, and after that I have to click so that pop-up will appear. So after that, this line will open the pop-up. Okay, after that I have to handle. So there is one method which is driver. This is an object, and inside that object, if I put dot, there is switch to. This is also one of the methods. Inside that, there is one method which is called alert. Okay, so you have to first switch your driver to the alert, and after that, okay, so as you can see, if I click this first button, this one, so here you can see this is called okay, which means we have to accept this okay. Okay, if I click this, you can see we have accepted this. So here, to click on okay, I will use one method which is accept, which means click on okay. So if I try to run this, so let us first run without this line. So what will happen if I click this? You can see that it is same. It has click, just click on this button and this pop-up appear. After that, what I have to do? So I have to do two things. First, I have to get this text, which is this one. So I want to fetch the text, and also I have to click on this button. Okay. How we can do? So let us first try to click on okay. This time if I uncomment it, you will see it will click on okay. So you can see that it has clicked on OK. So because we have provided this code, so if I want to get the text, so what is the text I want to get? If I click this, I want to fetch this text. I am an alert box. So how we can do? Again, there is one line for that. So let me first create one string variable having the name text, and I will write driver. So this time I want to fetch the text. So if I say driver.switch2.alert dot get me the text present on the alert. That's it you have to do, and after that let me print that as well. Hit enter and then click on this. So website opened, and so you can see that this time it will not click on OK because I have commented that part, but you will see this text in your output. So you can see that this is the text it fetched from the alert box. So this is how you can fetch the value from that, from this alert box. Okay, so let us try to do some more activity here. If I click OK, anyways, so if I come now, okay, let me open it in my original browser. So this is the I think it is here. Okay, so we have done this, and suppose this is the one. Click me. So here you will see a different JavaScript alert which is having more than one button. So cancel button is also there. So to handle that, again we will do the same thing. Okay, so let me first write the XPath, so I can click on this button. So this is the, I can go with this one button on click equals to. I'm writing the XPath button on click. Thank you. So 180 and matching, so which is correct, click me. So let me cut this, and after that what I will do, let me change this XPath mark. For the second button I will provide the XPath here, and after that it will click on the button, will open the pop-up again, second pop-up, and again let me fetch the text. So this time let me not fetch the text, this time I want to click on OK button again. So what I will do, driver dot system dot alert. So if you want to click on OK button, as you can see, if I click this, so if I click OK, you will see you pressed OK is written here. If I click again, click on cancel, so you will see the text changes to cancel. So let us try to click on cancel button this time. So if you want to click on OK, you know the method name, which is accept. If you want to click on cancel, you have to use the method dismiss. So alert dot dismiss. So this is the method. This will click on cancel button. Okay. So if it click on, so let us first try to execute this program. You will see that it will click on cancel button. So let us wait for that. So you can see that it has clicked on this button, and you will see here you pressed cancel. So is it clear to everyone that how we are dealing with this alerts?
Yeah, yes, Amit.
It is, I think, not much complex, as you can see. So there is one more, or you can say, button box, which is this one, click for prompt box. If I click this, you will see the different kind of, you will see different type of alert, which is, you have to, if I write my name here, click on OK, you will see you entered Sumit. So whatever the value you will write here, if I write like this, then you will see this. So, what I will do, again I will write the XPath first so that I will be able to open the button. So write, okay, let me first click on this, and let me write this one. So we have to write the XPath. So I can go with this one again. Button class, button on click equals to value. So write the XPath like this, button at the rate, you can say on click is my attribute equals to value. So if I hit enter, so what is the saying, only one element
on click is a C is caps, sir. This is small.
This is small. Yeah, it is a small. Okay. Thank you for telling. So if I hit enter. At the rate tag name, at the rate attribute equals to, I think there is some issue with the crow path going on. So if I press it here.
No, you have changed the value, on click value in the element cell.
Okay, let me do it again. Let me. Yeah, wait. So this is the button class. I think it is the one, right?
No. I think you need to refresh the page. Then only you'll get the exact value for on click.
Okay, so let me. Then I will refresh.
Okay.
Refresh this. So maybe. So this time let us try to see it again. So again we got this button on click goes to this on click. So I think its spelling is incorrect. Because to so if I hit, is this is the correct one? I think no. button is my tag name, @onclick. So again you can see the spelling is wrong, I have written. Okay, so this time it is correct, right? You can see 1 out of 1, which is this yellow one is our correct XPath. Copy this XPath. Okay, let me check it here as well. One element matching. So after that, I will again if I write it here. Okay, so this will open the pop-up. After that, what I have to do, I have to send some data. So for sending the data, first I have to switch to alert driver dot switch to dot alert and use method send. So let me write my name as well. If I right click and run this, so I will close this as of now. Okay, so I think we do not want to. Okay, so anyways, let me first comment this. We do not require this. Okay, we want to see the value. So let me run it again. So it has opened the lecture. So as you can see that even after the pop-up opened, it has not entered my name. And if you see the console, you will not get any error. So if you see here, there is no issue with our code. So this line is correct. But if I show you that there is some issue with the browser, it is not related to our. If I type here, alerts.sendKey is not working. So many people are getting this kind of error, right? You can see Selenium alert keys with the Chrome is not working. So you can see here it works perfectly with Fine in Chrome, but in Chrome it doesn't work, right? So if I open this link, right, so it is a kind of bug which is going on with the Chrome driver. So this is the reason our code did not work. So if I try to execute, let me open the link, right? So again, this is the official, I think, where they are getting the bugs from the people and they are trying to resolve that. So here the same issue is that I think it is here that this code works perfectly with Firefox, but Chrome driver is an issue. So let us try to run this code in Firefox browser. Okay, so if I want to run, then I have to change some parameters here. Geeko driver will come, and here I have to provide the Geeko driver path. So I think it is here. Copy the path. And I think it is, we have to provide it here. Okay. After that, I have to write the file. It is the file. Geeko driver. Save the one, and after that, change it here. Firefox. So okay, correct. Let me save it again. So this time, whatever the activity we are performing, this URL will going to open in Firefox browser, and this time again pop-up will appear, but this time you will see it will be able to enter the text in the box. So let us see. You can see, but here you can see the website user interface is different here, right, as compared to Chrome. You are getting this pop-up, but anyways, we have to understand the concept that how, if you are getting any kind of pop-up like this, then how you have to handle. So is it clear to you, everyone?
Yeah, yes, Samir. Then suppose if you use Chrome, how to overcome this issue?
So, unless the people will not resolve the bug that is going with the Chrome, so you cannot do that. You have to wait.
Oh, okay, okay. Even though if you upgrade or downgrade the Chromium Chrome version, we can't get it.
In the next Chrome version, they will resolve this issue. So then, sometimes it may so happen. So, anyways, we have to get the concept here. So this is the one, right?
Okay, I got it.
Okay. So,
Samir, what in case if there is a two option like username and password to enter? Then
I am coming to this after that. You can see here, this is the one that will ask window authentication and password, right? So I will come to this now. So this part is complete. Okay, so these are the JavaScript alerts. So there is one kind of alert as well. If I come, so Syed has asked to this, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so I am coming to this now. With the user. Let me. Okay, I will open it here. So there is one website. Let me open this. This is the website that will help us to understand this concept. If I click this, so you will see that you will find in many websites, right? So to navigate to the other page, I have to provide some username and password. Okay, so if I provide username is admin, and password is also admin. If I click on sign in, then you will see. This is the page you will get after you will click on sign in. So we have to do with the help of code. So let us try to do that. So let us first open the website. Okay, again. So let me come into this. So driver.get. And after that, this is the website, and after that, first we have to click, then only we will get the pop-up. So we have to click this. So this is a link. Okay, so what is the link text here? This is the link text. So I will go with the tag name. I will go with the locator link text to identify it. So driver dot find element by dot link text this time. What is the text? This is the text, and I have to click on that. So that my pop-up will appear. Okay, let me put some sleep, some wait after that. Okay, you can use implicit wait as well, but as of now, let me put like this only. So as you can see, let me try to run this first. Okay, so let me open the website as well. I think I have not opened. Okay, I already opened. So remove this. Okay, fine. I think. Oh, and let me do one thing as well. Let me, this time I will use Chrome browser. And what is the path of the Chrome driver? Again, I have to get this. So I think this is the copy this path. And from here to here, provide the path. Chrome driver.txt. Right? So this is the path. Yeah, fine. So let me try to run this, then we will see what is the we will get. Okay, so it has failed. Chrome driver. Okay, so we have to change this one as well. I will change this. Okay, then it will work. It was taking Firefox key as the key, so change this as well. Then it will run on Chrome browser. So you can see that it has clicked and we got this pop-up. So here I have to provide the username and the password. So we have to first, let us see what is the username and password, right? So if you see here, this is the user and password, right? You can see admin is the username and admin is the password. So what we will do when we will be providing this link. I think it is here. So what we will do, let me write it here. We will send username and password along with the link. with the URL, you can say. So here, this is the our actual URL. So when we are launching this URL, after this, provide the username first. So what is the username? Admin is the username. And after that, put colon, provide the password. So this is our password. And put at the rate. So what will happen? As soon as you get this pop-up, where is the pop-up? I think, yeah, this one. So as soon as you get this pop-up, okay, so I have already logged in, so this is the reason I am not seeing it again. So let me open it in incognito mode. So again hit the URL. So what I am saying, when this pop-up will appear, so we are providing the username and password in the link. So as soon as I click this, it will automatically provide the username and the password, and then it will click on the sign in button. So let us see how it will sign in. Okay, so let us see as well. Okay, so let me run it again. So I have provided the username, admin, password is the admin, and then the link is present. Okay, so let us check this time whether we are able to sign in or not. So you can see that it has executed very fast. So this is the reason you are not able to see. So is it clear to everyone that if you get these kind of window authentication pop-up, so to handle that, this alert code will not work, right? Which is accept and dismiss will not work. You have to provide like that because they are little bit different. Is it clear, Sahil?
Yeah, Sameer, it's clear.
Thank you. So. Thanks. Alerts we have covered, okay, whatever the alerts which we have covered. So this kind of pop-up we have also covered. So just send the this username and this password with the URL. So there is one more thing which we are going to discuss now, which is auto IT2. So to demonstrate that, let me open one website, which is Nokri.com. So close this. Okay, so here I think. Yeah, I can open it here. So if I open this, so if I click this upload CV, so you will see there is one window will open, right? So here what I will do, once I will get the window, I will find the resume. Where is my resume? I think wherever it is. So I have to upload this resume here, but so I want to write a code that can automate this. But here, if you see, let me come here. Selenium tool is designed to automate only web-based application, right? So Selenium will not be able to automate the window-based activity. So this pop-up, whatever you are seeing, this pop-up, yeah, it is not a web-based. It is a window-based pop-up. So Selenium will not be able to alone handle this pop-up and do the necessary operation which we have to do. So to do that, what we will do, we will actually, I think it is here, we will actually make use of one tool which is called Auto IT2. So is it clear to everyone? So what is the issue and what we are going to do in this lecture, in this third one, which is Auto IT2?
Yeah, Samit, we have to handle an desktop-based application here.
Yeah, you can say that desktop pop-up. Which is, you can see. Okay, so let us first download this Auto IT application. So let me first remove that application from this, because I am already having it. So I think I have stored it here. So this is the one, right? So as of now, let me delete this. I will again install it to show how you have to do the installation part. So after that, I will come to this website. I will write a download, not this one. Auto IT download. So come here, and after that, come here. Okay, so open the first link. This is the link. Here you will see, as you can see, Auto IT full installation, right? So click this button, click this link, and after that your setup will download. As you can see, it has downloaded, and after that, open this. So also you can see I have removed the setup. Okay, fine. So let me open this setup now. So I think it is completed, and let me run this setup. Click on yes. Okay, after click on this next button, click on I agree. Okay, so here you will see go with the default one. Okay, it is saying recommended, so go with this one. Do not change anything. Again click on next, and click on next again, and click on next again. After that you will see the path. So here it is, the path it is installing. So click on install. Click on finish. Setup is completed, and click close this. Okay, after that let me come where this is installed. So I will go to my program files. Here it is, the folder. Okay, so click this, and then you will see. So first of all, what we will do, let me click this SCITE. Okay, so inside that you will find one editor. So this is a editor, right? So just like we are having Eclipse editor, this is also one of the editor where we will write our code. Okay, so double click this. Okay, so I don't know why I'm having this code. Okay, so let me, because we have to do it from beginning, so let me remove this as of now. So this is one editor where we will write some code. Okay, so before that let me open one more tool. Okay, before tool let me open that pop-up again. So click this. This is the, you can say, so just like, so you cannot right click and get the HTML code for that. So just like HTML element, if you want to identify this, so how you can identify this? So there is one tool which is provided by AutoID. Let me come to this setup path again. So this is the where AutoID is installed, and open this AU3 info x64, right? So if I double click this, you will see one recorder will open. You can think of it as a recorder. Okay, so this will help us to identify this box. So here, what is the approach we are going to use to upload our resume? So first of all, I think here it is the one resume. Yeah, so suppose if I have to upload this resume, right? I will click this and open it. So I will first see what is the path of this. So it is the complete path. Copy the path. So this is the path. Paste the path here. And after the path, what is our file name? Which is resume-f_f.docx is our extension, because it is a Word file. So it is the extension of this file. So if I provide the path and after that the file name, okay, copy the path first. And if I hit this open button, then you will see our file will going to upload it. So you can see resume-f is uploaded successfully. So this is the strategy which we are going to use. Okay, so to do that, we have to write the code, because I do not want to do that manually. So again, let me open this. Let me open this again. So first of all, we have to identify this file name box. Okay, this is our edit box. So this is the finder tool, you can say. Click this and hold this. Click it and hold this and move this circle to this. Okay, so it is highlighting it, then release this. So after that you will find some window information here. Okay, you can see window information. Title is open. You can see the title on the top is open. Okay, and this is the class they have used, and this is the class. Here they are saying, and this is the instance. And there is one more, which is okay. So let me discuss it in a while. So these are the four you will require. Okay, so after that, so let me open my editor. So in the editor, I have to write my code, and these are the property which I got for the edit box. So first of all, I will use one method. I will use this control focus. Okay, so that will, okay, let me write it again. Control focus. So after that, if I paste like this, so right, so this is the title. It is expecting three things: title, text, and the control ID. So what is the title? You can see title is open. So let me write open in double quotes. Title is open. Okay, fine. After that, what is the text? So here, if I click on control, you will find the text. You can see the text is empty, right? So I am providing the text empty here. Provide the empty text here, and after that, it is expecting as the control ID. So what is the control ID? Actually, control ID is the combination of class and the instance. So if I want to write the control ID, what is the control ID will become edit one. So at the third parameter, I will write the control ID, which is edit one. After that, put bracket like that. So what this will do, this will set the focus. Okay, this will set the focus to this edit box. So our focus is here. Okay, as of now, understand that we are focusing this with the help of this code, this line of code, which is first one. After that, once focus is set, I have to provide the path. So to provide the path, I will send something. So here there is one which is set text. So I have to set the text in the edit box. So what is the text we have to set? This is the complete file path. Okay, so again it is expecting the title. So what is the title? I think title is again, because we are dealing with the edit box, so title is again going to be the same. So if I write open here, and after that, what we have to do? Okay, so text is here. If you see, click on control, text is again empty, right? So provide empty text, no issue. You can do like that. And after that, okay, so what we have to do? Provide, let me write it here first. Control text. Yeah, this is the one. If I see like this, so title we have provided, text we have provided, which is empty, control ID. So, and after that, new text. So what is this new text? This new text is your actual file path. So before that, we have to provide control ID again. So what is the control ID? Again, I am saying, actually control ID is the combination of class and an instance. So let us first write the title first. So open is the title, and after that, provide the text as blank. Control ID, third parameter is control ID, which is edit one. Actually, I should have written it on the top. Okay, anyways, I will write here. Provide like this, and after that, what we have to provide? So you see, after that, we have to provide the new text. So, okay, so do not consider this last one. Okay, it is not required. So we will consider this new text. Okay, so what is the new text here? If I say, so what is the path? So if I come to that file again, I think I have already copied that. Let us check. No, I have not copied that. So anyways, in the downloads folder, there is path, which is called resume. Oh yeah, this is the path. Click from property. And this is the file path. So we have to provide the file path here. Copy this. And after that, come here again to the editor. So provide the file path here. This is the file path. And after the file path, provide the file name as well. So what is the file name? Resume _f.docx is the extension, as it is a Word file. And after that, close the bracket. So what? Let me remove this, we do not require it. Okay, so first it will set the focus to the edit box, and after that, what I'm saying, in the edit box, place this path. This is the whole path, file path, you can say. So this whole file path will come here. Due to the second step, this path will come here like that. And after that, we have to click on open. So to click on open, again, I have to identify this open button. So how we can do with the help of this finder tool. So click this and just move it to here. Okay, so let me do it. I think I know that it clearly. So let me move it here. So you can see classes button, instances one, title is again open. Okay, so we got the, you can say, we got the some title and the class to identify this open button uniquely. So again, I will write what I have to do. I have to click this open button now. If I want to click this open button, what is the method I can use? I can use control click. So this is the method, right, to click on any button. After that, so again it is expecting the title. So what is the title this time? Title is open. And after that, okay, so after the title, what we have to do, I think we have to provide the text. And after that, again, control ID. So what is the control ID? Button one, combination of class and instance, or you can say the concatenation of class and instance. So control ID is class, sorry, button one. So that's it, we have to provide. And after that, what I have to do, that will complete the, you can say, if I click on open, so you can see after that it will install. Okay, it will actually upload that file. So before that, what we have to do, let me save the file. So close this, we do not require it anymore. Okay, so just click file and click on save as. So let's
do this. Sir, sorry to interrupt, sir.
Yeah.
Here is a text is undo open is here, sir, but you not put.
Okay, I got your point. So it's up to you, even if you want to provide, I think there is one text, you are right.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it's up to you whether you provide or not, it will work. Open this program files 86 auto IT, and I will just open this so that I can identify the open button. So if I click this, this open button has a text. So click this. So this is the text, I think. Yeah. And under ampersand open. So just copy this. So let me write it here. I will not be able to copy, I think. So you can provide the text here as well. Even if you do not provide, then also it will and open. Okay, after that, save this file. Okay, file, click on save as, and let us define, you can say, let us save with the name file. Okay, so you can give any name. And after saving, come here to the document folder. I think this is the file. Okay, this is the file name. And after that, what I will do, I will first see where it is present. So what is the path of this? So copy the whole path. And after that, okay, so after that, what I will do, click on this. Okay, so in Java, after we will click on, okay, so what I will do, let us first write one code so that we can click this. With the help of Selenium, we can do that easily, right? Selenium will be able to automate this. So let us first open the website. This is the website, and after that, website is open. Let me click on this upload CV button. So if I want to click on this upload CV button, I have to write one X bar, as you all know. Or you can write any locator. Okay, here I am just writing X bar. You can go with CSS or any other locator as you want. So I can go with this one, title. So label title equals to this. So tag name is label. At the rate title, what is the title here? Yeah, after that hit enter, you can see two elements matching. So we are interested only in first one. So let me write one here. So to deal with the two only one, we have to provide. Okay, so I think there is some issue in the crop path going on. So let me write it here and paste it here. Then we'll check. So you can see if I paste it like that, it is saying 1 out of 1, which means only one element is highlighted, and it is highlighting this. You can see upload CV button as well. So this is our correct XPath. Copy the XPath and then just paste it here. Okay, remove this. Driver dot find element by dot XPath. And after this, what we have to do, we have to click this upload CV button. Okay, so when you will click this upload CV button, it will take some time for this pop-up to come. Okay, so let us put some weight. So let me put 5 seconds. Okay, after that, what we have to do, we have our code here in this file. Okay, so with the help, there is one class in Java which is called runtime, and there is one method which is get runtime here. Inside that, there is also one more method which is execute. So here, whatever the file path you will provide, it will be executed. Okay, whatever the file path you provide, after that, that file will be executed, and we are having our whole code of handling that pop-up in that file. So I think I have saved the file here. If I come it here, so this is the file. Okay, so what is the file path? If I right click property, this is the file path. Copy this file path and commit, paste it here. Okay, and after that, write the file name. I think the file name is file itself, but here, if you see, this file is not an executable file. If I right click and show you the extension of this file, this is .auc extension, but we want, okay, so Java will be able to execute executable file, not this file. So to make this file executable, right click, and when I was installing AutoIT, I just choose this x86, I hope you remember. So compile the script with the help of this only. So click on this compile. And after that, you will get one executable file. You can see, I think if I click this, you can see .exe file is this. So we will execute this file. So after that, provide the file name and what is the extension, .exe. That's all you have to do. And what will happen once, so you will see that once when I will run the program, if I run that again, see what will happen. This time it will upload the resume which we have provided in the, you can say, editor. So let us try to execute this. So you can see it has opened the editor. So I think it has not pasted the required file. Okay, anyways, we will check what is the issue here. Okay, so I think after 5 seconds it will upload maybe. Okay, I think I have moved my mouse. Let me run it again one more time. It has failed. The system cannot find the file specified. So is the file name is, okay, I will run it again. Let me run it again. Website is open, and then after 5 seconds you should enter the URL, not URL, actually the file path. So it is not able to. Okay, so what is the issue? Let us check. I think I have made some mistake in that editor. So let us check. Is there any issue here? You are seeing. So let me check. We are providing this as correct, I think. After that, open. So I think everything is correct. So writer is not finding the required file that you put in this path. See, user submit coil documents file.txt. So I think I provided everything correct, then write is thing. If I right click, open this, see user submit coil documents. Okay, after that, this is the file name with the extension. So let me save it again one more time. So let me try to save it again. So this time let me save it with demo, anything you want. So click on save. Compile this so that we can get one executable file. So this is the file, and after that click on property. And I think this is the number for complete part. So click on this. I think everything is correct. Let me check one more time so our testers will not fail. I think everything is correct. So let me close this. And after that, what is the file path? I think this time it will have demo. Is it capital D or small D? Yeah, it is a small D.
Double slash or single slash before the exe file?
Yeah, that will be correct. Okay, so let me try to run this again. This time it should work. Size open. So you can see that. So have we deleted the file? File not found. I think the file name is different. Let us check first whether it is the correct file. I think it is the correct file. What is the path of this file? See users submit coil document. File notes. File not found. So if I but here the file is present. Why it is again, let me do it one more time. So let me do one thing. Let me open that in maximize mode. Maybe that is maybe that reason we are getting the driver. Work manage, work window, work maximum. Okay, let us check this time. It has opened it again. File not found, click on file name in gallery. Okay, so I think I've even it is pasting the correct path. I think where it is the file. There is something wrong with the file path. And this is the one. Here it is the one. Right, enter our code. So, see users. I don't think that it is due to this. Let us check. Okay, by giving it this empty this time. I don't think that will be an issue, but let us check. Okay, so maybe that it will not be able to identify with the input text. So I mean, let me see the file.
Is your resume in document or a download folder?
Sorry?
Your resume is in document folder or download folder?
I think it is in document, let me check.
Oh, okay.
I think it is in download folder, you are right.
Download, sir.
Yeah, it is in download folder, so.
It's download folder.
Yes, that's the reason it's throwing error.
But I think I have copied it from here only, I think. Then we got, I think, documents. Because I have not written the path, I have just copied it maybe. Okay, so anyways, I think this is the issue. Yeah, downloads will come here. Okay, so let me write. So I think what is the text here? And
open.
Yeah, so I don't know how we got documents here because, okay, I will see that later in the recording. Because I have copied the path, but still I got document here, I don't know how. So, anyways, okay, so I have to save that. I closed that mistakenly. So, this PC and program files. Open this and let us save this time. File, save as. There you go. File. Let's save. Close this. Back to the path where you have saved your file. What is the path? It is here. In documents. So demo file is the one. First of all, compile this so that we can get one executable file. So you got this file. Okay. Now what we will do? We will copy. We will see the path. I think I got the document from here, maybe, I'm not sure. Anyways, so just change the file name here, which is demo file. So I think this time it should work correctly. So I think the file name is correct. Okay, so if I try to run this time, let us check. It has opened and it will click on upload CD button with the help of Selenium. And after that, Auto IT will end. So this time you can see that it has clicked and it has uploaded the required file. So is it? I think you are able to see that it happened very fast. Is it clear how you can upload this file with the help of Auto IT?
Yes, Amit, it is clear.
It's okay,
sir.
Okay. So what I will do, I will share this code in the classroom, okay, and also will upload the recording of today. We will see some more concept in the other lecture, but as of now it is sufficient for today, okay.
Thanks, Amit.
Thank you everyone for attending today's session.